Welcome.
It's Brando.
How are we doing?
We've got five beers here. All from different breweries, all very unique in its own style. First up is the Black Acid. And this is a collaboration brew from Lervig. Cool. Product of Norway. I don't say.
Yeah, I this is one of the beers I managed to pick up from Oxbat Brewery.
Mm.
They do a lot of European beers in there. They mix it up on that.
And it's basically a lambic blend aged in akivit barrels, 8.5%.
That's what caught my interest, the different style that they've gone for. With the
I'm trying to think of the collaborations. The branding looks familiar. But anyway, it's the Black Acid. So where did you buy this one from?
Oxbat Brewery.
Brewery.
Like I said, they have a nice selection of European beers in there, varying from like Danish to Polish to as well as I even saw some Estonian beers. But they do mix up a little bit.
Yeah. No head retention. It kind of looks like cherry cola or Dr Pepper, depending on your preference.
It just smells like it. Like, I'm guessing
there's
this
a slight reddish hue on there.
I'm guessing it might be like a sour beer.
Yeah, it's a lambic. Do get the hint of alcohol straight away.
Very sweetness on the smell. It does taste like cola.
Does it?
We had a beer yesterday, I think it was like cherry.
From Magic Rock.
And it's supposed to be cherry cola, Budweiser. It's so wrong. But this one is a better version of it.
Variation.
Oh, variation, sorry.
It's nice.
8.5.
You do get the alcohol initially, but on the flavour, it's just nice and smooth, easy drinking.
Honestly, take it as as if you've got a lot of cherry cola sweets, sugar, sour sweets.
And it's been aged in akivit barrels. I'm not too sure. I tried to use my phone to try it though.
Yeah.
But that's a nice beer.
Akivit.
8.5%.
Not too bad.
No?
Get a little smokiness on one, but no.
The next beer is brewed in Melbourne. This is their Friday beer from it's Black Hill Stout, weighing at 4.7%.
Picked this up in a local shop in Horsham. They specialise in a lot of craft ales, real ales, south.
So the actual brewery is called Friday Beer Company?
Yeah.
Okay, well, this is a new brewery for me. Very simplistic artwork on the bottle. And it's nice. It's nice how it tells you where it's brewed. I just put a warning on it. Yeah, that is. So this is a real ale. Smells nice. It's probably the most traditional one out of the five we've got here.
Yeah. See how lively it is.
When we've been on our road trips, we've visited many breweries no one's ever heard of, but
it does smell like a classic rich stout.
Yeah, a slight bit of cherry notes, a little bit of burnt wheat almost.
Yeah, it's quite thick, isn't it?
Yeah. But it's a quite lively beer.
Almost a little bit burnt toffee there. Yeah, you get that lovely liquid smell, taste. I mean,
what is that taste? It's like the tobacco almost.
Yeah, like a smoky taste.
No, like I've got tobacco in my mouth. In fact, like Golden Virginia.
Yeah, you do get.
Because I have it when it was younger. I used to have on the Gone to Virginia.
But
it's got like
it's got me thinking now. It's like us Black Hill Stout, and we have a place nearby.
In like, Horsham.
Not in Horsham.
In
Yorkshire.
Oh, okay.
Called Black Hills.
Oh, for camping with the scouts. For
scouts and stuff, and it just makes me think.
Yeah.
Like a campfire sort of thing.
It is very lively beer.
It does have a little smoky smell though. You do get like a smoky taste.
Yeah, nice texture. Not bad beer. Considering it's a nice traditional conditioned ale, 4.7%. And a new brewery.
Yeah, it's nicely done.
And next one is from Beavertown, and it's the Tempest Project, and it's the Hooktown Monk.
With this one, I picked up from in a place in Guildford called In at Home.
Okay, cool.
It's a nice bottle shop, and they've got a good selection of beers, from local ales to craft ales to popular beers from up north, down south.
This is a brewery from London. It's a Belgian rye triple aged in white wine barrels.
It's Beavertown Tempest Project.
Yeah.
I mean, so this Tempest Project is...
I don't even know if it's a... What's it? I hope it's not a cork. We ain't got a cork with this.
Oh,
it's just a big boy cap. I was going to show you what Andrew calls it. This is a bottle cap.
What it is...
See, it's a fraction bigger.
We did have... some beers from Europe, Italy, Spanish, they had similar style bottle, but with a cork in it.
I think it's got like a... It says it's got a tree on it, and I think it says...
It really sour smell to it, again.
It's not a tree. $10.99 Jeez. I thought Rob Dabish a little bit. So, colour is slightly easy. Little edge retention.
Smell is quite a sour fruitiness.
Yeah, there's a slight tartness on the smell, like apricot tarts and stuff like that. Like, you know, when you get jam tarts and there's like there's raspberry, there's strawberry, and there's the apricot one. Also, sometimes there's lemon.
On the taste wise, you get more of the same. You get that lambic taste coming through. And same again with the apricot.
You get the white wine.
You get the apricot.
You get the white wine. I'll see the ABV on this one. I had wine for a while, so.
9.3.
It kind of can give a little bit of a perry note sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah, you do get that wine taste coming through. It's like...
The more you drink it, it does come more pleasurable, and you get a little bit of apricot, a little bit of peach. A little bit of soft peach. That's not bad beer. But £11, Andrew. Jesus.
Well, what interested me with this one was just a Belgian...
Yeah, for sure. Oh, and if you're going to get a big boy beer like that, you share it with good people. Next one up is the Titanic Brewery. This was £3.50.
We've tried this. We've had this beer so many times.
And I think it's a camera favourite. The original, anyway.
Which is like what percent is the pump out?
Probably like about 5%.
Yeah. Well, they've got a Grand Reserve one. So I thought, well, I think see the difference.
I think this is. There's a Grand Reserve, and there's another one now. There's like three variations of the Plum Porter.
Yeah.
I think the other one comes with a bigger bottle. But me and Andrew have visited, like... we've
been to the Titanic
Park. Yeah. And it's still funny, that story of Andrew Titanic Brewer. When all the brewers came running out, when Andrew basically left the brake on his car, and then when he pulled that rock to say goodbye, he almost lost the bottom of his car.
I want it in rental as well.
That's probably why I left the Brickley's. It wasn't used to it, but people.
They would care, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I want my old school.
Oh, is that the glass? No, but yeah, Pump Art is one of the first beers that we started trying. let's have a look. So the difference between this and the Plum Porter, this is higher ABV, probably a little bit more texture, detail.
Lovely plum smell.
You do get the plum straight away.
It just smells like plum jam.
Based on our multi-award winning Plum Porter, our Plum Porter Grand Reserve is dark, added strength, and elevated roundness due to the increased alcohol, which is so the usual bar.
Just so tastes like it's got plum jam in your mouth.
Oh, natural plum flavouring. So it's no plums in it, it's flavouring. But yeah, it doesn't say. I don't know if it's pasteurised. So it might be pasteurised. So it might be pasteurised bottle. So it might not be lively, so I don't know if you could age this beer.
Mm. It is very nice though. You know what I mean? You get that lovely plum taste.
Yeah. It's a lovely beer. As always, you don't detect the alcohol. You just get a light cotton ball. Jeez, that white wine beer. Cotton ball texture on the back of the throat is when you need a little bit of final beer.
This one? That one, yeah?
Yeah. Dr. French's, which is from a local brewery, it's Weltons. Weltons Brewery. Basically, they've collaborated with Tomintoul to make.
Glenlivet?
Yeah, so this is the Speyside Glenlivet single malt Scotch whiskey version. We had one the other day, which was the rye. This is the Old Remedy, total with for 1 year. The alcohol content is 8.3%. The other one was a red wax. This is a black wax top.
Yeah. Give me this.
Got it.
Scratch the wax.
And we'll kill us if we get it on the floor. Shit. You didn't drop it on the floor.
I'm all.
Saw someone on this, didn't I?
It was more of a don't get in the beer.
Yeah. Because
last time you ended up in the floor. So.
Well, it's darker than this one. The other one was a little bit more reddish. This is like cola. Black. What's that black? You know when you clean the grill at work, you get that water, it comes out black.
We've gone on about dark beers, right? And saying they smell like cola. That smells like. Call it again.
But anyway, cheers. Smooth. That is nice.
Get that smooth, like a whiskey malt coming through.
That's nice. I do like that the collaborations with Tomintoul and Weltons. Yeah, Weltons.
Yeah.
They all come with these little booklets to tell you about the whiskey that's been associated with the beer. But that's pretty cool. This is a really nice beer.
That is very smooth.
I think we really enjoyed the other one as well.
Yeah, the other one was just as good as well.
Yeah. But they've all just been launched. I mean, you were lucky to get these because apparently there's a small batch. Mm. But
does it say what batch this one is?
This is this first batch. This is basically the first one that they've done.
Yeah.
Yeah, this and the one that we had the other day. But yeah, lovely beer.
It says here, best before 2020. So it's like considering it saying.
I think we said the with the other one, it was really, really good. And that was fresh.
Mm.
And for aging, it could probably just get better.
Yeah.
So, round it off. The black acid was good, the black ale stout was good, the white wine bottle was good, they were all good beers.
Yeah.
But which was your beer of the five?
It's got to be the Plum Thought.
You prefer that one?
Very plummy. It just, but I don't know, it varies because they're all, you know,
they're all good in their own way, and it's nice to see different styles of beers in different ways. You got whiskey barrel aged, you've got traditional, you've got
white wine one.
Amplified, you've got white wine, and you've got a sap, a lambic.
Yeah.
But that Dr. French is for me, it's just really nice and smooth. And just as like the other one, so I'd be interested to see what the other Welton beers are. But that was my favourite. But yeah, the Plum Porter just reminds you how good the original Plum Porter that we all know and love here in the UK.
That's it. I mean, it just, it's a good round beer. With this one, you get a lot of plummy taste to it. I don't know if it's stronger
I think it's amplified the alcohol content, but I think that is pasteurised, because it doesn't mention if it's a live beer.
Yeah.
The Beavertown was really good, but that white wine just knocks you straight. I couldn't talk properly. Oh, I have that properly. But all good beers. Definitely check them out. Would I buy any of them again? I'd probably buy, if I see the Dr. French's from Weltons, that I'd buy again. Anyway. You take care.